Welcome to second steel making course lecture 18. Let me give the preamble about secondary refining process such as vacuum arc remelting process and electro slag remelting process. There was a problem. Even you are maintaining the ladle metallurgy operations, deoxidation, desulfuration, decarburation, and some of the vacuum degassing methods, even then you are not going to meet with respect to the properties and applications high quality of steels for the production of stainless steel, high quality, and the space applications, nuclear applications, and other automobile applications. Then that particular situation demands going for the few more secondary refining process nearby the steel making operations, steel mills, such as vacuum arc remelting process and electro slag remelting process. Even this thing is small scale, but it is necessary with respect to the defense applications, nuclear applications, where these things are prepared. For other applications, it may not be necessary. Then this route is not followed. The cost is not effective economically. Operations, you need to put the more capital investment for developing these operations. In that situations of nowadays, in the present situation, to meet these particular requirements, such as low gas content, hydrogen and nitrogen, cleanliness, inclusion free, less inclusions, homogeneity, there should not be any segregation existence. In that particular situation, even you are preparing the conventional melting route, steel making and continuous casting by maintaining the Tundish technology and continuous casting process, vacuum induction furnace, these alone are not meeting this requirement. So there is a need to add for these particular billets, taking as a electrode or starting ingot for remelting, that is remelting technology is adapted. For achieving these particular additional advantages to increase the cleanliness at the end of the product, this particular things are developed. This particular technology involves you use that particular casting billet, bloom or slab converted into the round shape rod, long length rods with a specific dimension and length and diameters. It could be the 90 centimeter to 100 centimeter diameter. These things vary and chosen as electrode, long length electrode. And it is consumable electrode. By consuming this particular electrode, you will be refining by the process of using vacuum arc and electro slag remelting, or you can call it as a refining process, where you will be achieving the cleanliness, less of the inclusions, and improved further fatigue strength and creep strength, tensile strength of the material. Those remelting furnaces are such as electro slag remelting and vacuum arc remelting. These both are used as ingots, electrode ingot. Finally, it gives the ingot metal. As for the mold shape, copper molds are preferably used in these particular things. You will be getting the high quality of material. Nowadays, out of these particular techniques, vacuum arc is finding extending in all the industries for the specifically high quality and large steel ingots in the entire old community of the steel shops. Now this is a broad schematic of vacuum arc remelting process design. This is the electrode after continuous casting, where you did not achieve the high quality and high gas content, inhomogeneity. That particular thing is billet is made into the round shape electrode, having the holder with the mechanism of feeding slowly from the top, and provided the, in the case of vacuum arc, vacuum seal. This is a above the ground, this is a below ground. This particular pot is copper mold and holotype copper mold. Continuously the water is cooled with this within this particular mold. Water inlet, water outlet. And this is the electrode. This is the fixed one. And this is the consumable electrode which you are going to remelt. Consumable electrode, remelt and refine, you are going to get the high quality of steel. This is dummy electrode and attached. This is welded and this is solidified. This is arc and it melts, and after solidified, this is called ingot, a round ingot of mold shape, metal ingot. Finally, you are going to get which is having the high quality and good properties, mechanical proper, improved mechanical properties. And the process, vacuum arc remelting process is, this is simply water cooled ingot mold in maintaining the vacuum chamber. Ingot mold, ingot metal you are going to get with the copper mold. Mold use mold mainly made up of copper with the circulation of the water system continuously, so that continuously you can solidify. By the end of the process, solidification and everything finishes with the less of casting defects. But it is capital investment is higher. The chamber is initially evacuated and filtered, the pressure to 10 to the power of minus 5 bar was maintained. To effectively produce this high quality of vacuum arc remelt ingots, the electrode material must be come from high quality, made of, it should be either made from the vacuum induction melt or continuous casting melt. Those things are taken out as a electrode, and the current process, the main principle, the current flows from electrode which you are going to remelt and convert into the high quality of steel, from the electrode to mold. Within the mold, this particular electrode has been consuming, it convert into the ingot metal. So electrode to ingot mold, initially maintaining the lower pressure, slowly you increases the voltage and pressure. The electrode is consumed and lowered automatically with the driven mechanism slowly by maintaining the arc length and ingot. Maintaining it, it is being directed. The you will be using in the case of this vacuum arc melting straight polarity principle electrode and negative with direct current only in the case of vacuum arc melting. This point also you need to remember at this stage. And finally, it is allowed to cool simultaneously. You can observe the microstructure of that particular thing. These kind of things are suitable for wide range of applications. And high temperature mainly used for to break down these impurities, to remove these particular inclusions. Inclusions are split out and less of the, and manganese also evaporated. And lower pressure maintains degassing, removing the further oxygen and nitrogen. If it is removed, it is been evaporated. That is main advantage. Coming to the electroslag remelting process design, it is similarly, this is dummy electrode, fixed one welded to the consumable electrode. This is a consumable electrode which we are going to remelt and refine and get this particular thing into converting into the ingot metal, and which will be having the high quality of properties, improved mechanical properties and free from inclusions, cleanliness, homogeneity, less of segregation will be observed. And this is also very much similar. You will be having the copper mold, this is a ground and this is above ground copper mold, and circulated with the water inlet and water outlet. This is a slag. since it is this furnace is open to the atmosphere, there will be slag formation, slag bath, and this is liquid, slowly it is going to be solidified, and this is power source connected, the bottom dummy electrode and top electrode is being connected so that positive and negative is polarity is maintained, the current passes from the electrode to and the ingot dummy plate, steel plate which was arranged inside the copper mold. For initially while the arc is being initiated, there will be a struck because you will be pouring the continuously the slag which is calcium fluoride, the special slag powder is being used in this situation, you will be pouring and which helps to do not struck with the this mold and ingot mold, the dummy electrode and this electrode and desired electrode should not struck. So this slag material slowly by providing the vibration, the technician and engineers, everybody will be observing. Finally, you will be success and you will be getting the good surface finish. And as the process is finished, you can take out, the tapering is been provided for the easy removal. The solidified ingot you can take out. The structure also, as we studied, mainly it is skilled steel. The structure will be the dendritic structure, columnar grains, and chilled zone will be there near the mold surface. And after that columnar grains, in the center zone there will be equaxed grain structure you can observe in this particular ingot metal. Now the brief procedure of this particular electroslag melting, the construction and the principle is similar to the VAR furnace, but the difference is no vacuum requirement is being used in the ESR. The furnace is kept open for the atmosphere. The mold is made up of copper with the circulating system similar to the VAR process. The top of this particular furnace and copper ingot is mold is kept open to the air. The electrode is being driven through the mechanism similar to the as automatically continuously there will be current flows from the electrode to the base dummy plate, similar kind of the electrode, or you can use iron alloy, and through the slag powder which provide the resistance of the slag between the electrode, consumable electrode and base plate, iron alloy base plate, so that it get not stuck. This resistance slowly gives the builds of the temperature. You can get the around 1600 degrees Celsius temperature also within few minutes. The tip of the electrode is slowly, as the molten metal is developing, the tip of the electrode is dipped into the slag layer so that the slag is floated and this particular slag can be removed once the operation is finished. You can take out, the tapering has been provided. This ESR having the facility of either you can use AC or DC, and straight polarity electrode and negativity, and reverse polarity such as electrode and positive. You can change step down transformer, alpha to delta, all those things are maintained for this particular ESR technology, mainly used for the specific applications where you need high quality. There should be a very low gas content, impurities should be there in the metal. After the steel making operations, second steel making operations, these things also adapted. Most of the steel plants are attached with VAR and ESR. That is why since it is connected to the this secondary steel making operations, it is been included in this particular chapter. The major difference is the slag powder usage is extra in the case of ESR, and the component also, the slag component is mainly made up of calcium fluoride. Even it also includes lime, magnesia, alumina and silica. keep this particular point important. The process and principles are very important with respect to the competitive exams and all those things. Now coming to the, this is practical view of electroslag remelting furnace. This is above the ground, you can see very much clearly. This is the copper mold, water inlet, water outlet, and one can be provided the electrical supply. And this is in the case of vacuum arc remelting. This is vacuum chamber and flow valves and the rotary pump, and flow will be maintained, constant water flow. You will be getting the low melt rate in the case of VAR and ESR. Now we will see the structure difference. The principal structure difference is, if you see VAR and ESR, the electrode, consumable electrode is existing, and mold, copper mold is same. Slag forms in the ESR. In the case of VAR, no slag. Arc is generated in the case of VAR. In the case of ESR, arc is initiated and slowly it immerses in the slag powder and molten metal flow. So arc diminishes, and initially it exists and diminishes, and liquid metal exists, liquidus and solidus. It continuously solidifies by the provision of inlet water and outlet water. The structure, this is finally ingot metal, remelted ingot, which was high quality of material, which is bowl shape round, only you use DC, and this particular final product shapes could vary from the round, square and rectangle based on the mold, copper mold. And another difference between the VAR, since you are using the vacuum, the minimum gas content will be there in the final ingot metal. And another thing is, vacuum has been maintained, the trace elements, another impurities such as other impurities also, nickel, copper, oxygen also, very low the presence. And here there is no vacuum, so the constant hydrogen present, and the slag reactions helps to minimizing the sulfur content in the final ingot metal. Since the pressure is controlled, the manganese loss is low. Here there is no pressure controlled, so no manganese loss existence. And another point in the case of ESR, the dendrite spacing, interdendrite spacing within the columnar grains is very less, and uniform distribution of carbide will occur within this particular dendrite. And here such kind of things need not to happen. It is, since it is maintained vacuum, there will not be such kind of structure. And white spots are possible in the case of kind of crown shape, torus, because of this particular electrode, from the electrode which was coming from the outside atmosphere. There may be less material loss in the case of ESR, as it has been liquidified from, as the slag is being poured, resistance heating, the white spots, all those things are very less. And finally, you also feed the aluminium wire so that oxygen presence in the final ingot metal will be less, and it maintains the high affinity of oxygen, the aluminium, that is why. And if you maintain the inert gas, there will not be reoxidation will occur for the final ingot. And the electrode must be removed, and you can remove once it has been solidified. This particular chamber type is, since it is exposed to the atmosphere, you can easily remove by providing the pattern making dimensions, tapering, and electrode can be used as cast condition sent to the forging section. Cleaning of the slag itself cleans. You can remove the slag, you will be getting the smooth surface finish. In the case of this thing also, you need to machine before the forging. The surface is not smooth, because those particular impurities are evaporated in the form of droplets or deposited on the ingot metal, you need to machine. And for this situation, not required, the dendrite arm spacing very low, secretion also very low. And since lowest melt rate is possible in the case of VAR, in this case moderated melting rate, there will be equal dendrite spacing. The parameter difference between the ESR and VAR, the diameter of the electrode is 90 cm in the case of VAR, in the case of ESR 100 cm, and this is the energy consumption is 1100 and 700 kilowatts hour per ton. Melting rate is 9 kgs per minute in VAR, in the case of ESR 13 point. And the welding for the dummy metal and the consumable electrode is the welding strength and the welding stuff is takes 8 hours. And the gases, when you are talking about nitrogen, hydrogen removal, there will not be any modification, constant in the case of ESR. And in the case of this thing, nitrogen, hydrogen is 50% reduced, manganese 30% of manganese is evaporated, deposited as the droplets form. This particular thing is almost maximum homogeneity is maintained by the inert atmosphere maintenance, and in the form of slag it goes out, you will be getting the homogeneity. And surface finish, electrode surface preparation is required in the case of you need to ground and you need to prepare. Normally it is not no need to ground after vacuum is been removed, so you can do as it is and you can send to the forging. This thing after remelting you can do with the surface also, the surface impurities also you can remelt within the vacuum furnace without ground. You can finish it, but it is, you need to take out from this particular whatever the impurities are deposited in the VR and the ingot metal, and you need to remelt and you need to remove the surface phenomena and surface structure and give your opinion on this particular point that ESR VAR necessary after secondary steel making operations to get high quality of steel with respect to the specific applications such as defense applications, nuclear applications, space applications. Give your opinion. Thank you.